children, I hope all of you are fine. So let's see what are we going to read today. Today we are going to read literature, class 6, chapter number 11, Escape to the Island. So when we read the topic, what does come in our mind? Like, what do you think? Like, if you get a chance to escape or break free from this everyday regular life, where would you like to go? Yes, that will be depending on your point of view, your perspectives. Here, this story is actually taken from the book, that is The Swiss Family Robinson. And we will read so much things from this story, how we have to take care of our family in any of the situation, and many more things. First and foremost, before beginning, we would first do this. Let's see what's the knowledge of our island. Let us know whether we have the appropriate knowledge about islands or not. Let's have a look on it. So in the first, it is asked, fill in the blanks using your knowledge about islands. So children, just give it a try and see whether you have written it correctly or not. You would have to use a dash to reach an island from the land. So I hope you all know what is an island. An island is basically a piece of land covered by water bodies all around. Okay, so how you are going to reach island? Since it is covered by water bodies all around, so you are either going to use a ship or you are going to use a boat. And definitely it's very common, you can say, if you are living in an island, you will be a good swimmer. Yes, let's go to question number 2. Name the islands that are close to your country. Like, it is Andaman and Nicobar Island as well as Lakshadweep Island. Name two islands that are also countries, like Japan and New Zealand. I hope you all have written it. So when we read this story, we will read about a family. They have decided they are going to travel to Australia on a ship. But there is a tragedy in the story. While going, their ship is caught in a fierce storm and crashes into a rock near an island. So let's see what happens next. I have even kept the cover page of the book, the real book from where the extract is actually taken. That is The Swiss Family Robinson. First and foremost, let us know the characters who are there in the story. The first character is narrator, Mr. Robinson. Okay, narrator, like the whole story is based on his perspective, his point of view. Whatever words or lines are written, it is said by him. So it is in direct speech. The second character is Mrs. Robinson, wife of Mr. Robinson. There are four kids of them. They are as such, are like Fritz, Ernest, Franz and Jack. So all the characters, please remember, children. Let us begin the story then. The storm raged for 7 days. It increased in fury until on the 7th day we gave up all hope. We were utterly exhausted by then, trying to keep ourselves safe from the storm. There was an island not very far from where we were. However, it was impossible to reach because of the storm. So continuously the storm was raging. Okay, it was continuously, the storm was there for 7 days, and on the 7th day also it was not going away. They were all worried. Okay, they gave up all hope that we are not going to survive this thing. By that time they all got exhausted, they got tired. Okay, but one thing was there, that they could see an island, but the difficulty was that they could not reach to that island. Okay. My heart sank as I looked at my family in the midst of these horrors. Our four young sons were terrified. My wife looked brave, and as the boys clustered around her, she began to cheer and encourage them with calm and loving words. So as you can see in these lines also, the narrator, Mr. Robinson's point of view is shown, what he is thinking, how he is feeling, all those things would be done or would be said in this story, are there in this story. Okay, so that's very obvious. If the person is there in a trouble or seeing his family in trouble, he will get worried. He's like, he was not knowing what is to be done. So as he was able to see the sons were not very like matured when they were young ones, so they were all terrified after this incident, the raging of the storm. But one thing you can see, the wife, the female character, is a little braver one. Okay, she is now collecting all the boys all together. She is encouraging them. She is saying some calm words and some loving words so that the children don't get afraid of the situation. Like, we generally see this characteristics of in our mothers, isn't it? Whenever there is any trouble in our family, or if she is facing something, or we are like the whole family, the elder ones knew if any situation, bad situation is coming in our life. So what they do? They encourage us that no, everything will be fine, there is nothing wrong, we will manage. So these are all the characteristics you will see here of Mrs. Robinson's also. She is a very brave woman who is encouraging the kids as well as the male character of the family. "We must find some food and take a good supper," said my wife. "We cannot fast for too long or it will make us weak. We will need all our strength tomorrow." So the female character, Mrs. Robinson, is like, they have already fasted, they have not eaten from like 7 days because of the storm. So being a human, you cannot survive too long without eating, isn't it? So she is suggesting, or you can say she is advising, that we need to have some food, otherwise we won't be able to continue, or we won't have the strength for tomorrow, isn't it? Soon it was night and the storm was as fierce as ever. At intervals, we were startled by crashes. These crashes announced further damage to our unfortunate ship. So again, the storm is again raging, it's fierce and all. Again, it's a very, very high tide and all. And like within, after some times and all, crashes are coming again and again, again and again. Because of these crashes, what happened? The ship is getting like broken, no? It gets damaged. But a good meal was now ready and the children ate it all up. The smaller ones fell asleep soon after. Fritz, who was in age of to be aware of the real danger we were in, kept watch with us. So yes, like, you all children also, you are mature enough, you know what is going on in your family, or like the real danger or difficult situations which you are going through. You all are of that age that you understand that. Same goes with Fritz as well. He was a little mature boy. He was knowing that they were in trouble. So he was keeping a watch on everyone, whereas the smaller ones, they all slept. After a long silence, he said, "Father, don't you think we might contrive swimming belts for mother and the boys? With those, we might all escape to land. For you and I can swim." So as you can see the maturity here, children, like how the boy is suggesting the father that we can create something like swimming belts and all. I hope you all have seen when you are going for any river area or in a boat, they give you swimming belts. So in the similar manner, they can create something like that for the mother and the smaller ones so that they can escape to that land and save themselves from this situation. And he is even ready to swim with the father. Okay. "We immediately searched about for what would answer the purpose, and fortunately got hold a number of empty flasks and tin canisters, which we tied together with rope so as to form float belts." So as you can see, this is tin canisters. So being empty, it will definitely float in water. That was the real idea. So what they thought, that if they could tie this whole thing around the waist of those mother, the other kids and all, so it will act as this float belts. Like, this is how we use it nowadays. Okay, but they didn't have these things, so they were trying to create this one with the help of these tin canisters. Next, by morning, the storm has aroused the boys. We assembled on the remaining portion of the deck. As you can see the picture of deck. Okay. Like, it is the top outside floor This is the outside floor of ship, as you can see. We decided to search the ship to see if we can find something useful. I started looking for the supplies of provisions and fresh water within our reach. I knew they were of great importance. So you'll ask me, ma'am, what does provisions mean? So let me tell you beforehand. Provision means like supply. So whenever people are going for a longer journey or they are going for a little greater distance, if they are covering, they carry with them extra amount of food as well as fresh drinking water with them. So that is said to be as provisions. Okay, so they all started, like, he was thinking, the main character, that is the narrator, Mr. Robinson, he is thinking that he should look for these kinds of food if it is available, because it will definitely help them out. No, like, they are of very great importance. When we had finished searching, we reassembled in the cabin. They all got back and gathered here in the cabin. They all were displaying the treasures. So every character bought some of the thing. Let's see what they all brought. The eldest one brought Fritz. Fritz brought flasks of water. Ernest produced a cap full of nails, a pair of large scissors and a hammer. Many kinds of other tools struck out of all his pockets. Even little Franz carried a box of supplies. So you can see every character in the story is helping each other out. They are bringing something or the other which they think would be helpful to them in the future. Let's move to next page, children. You can take out page number 148. Well done, Franz, I said. So, like how our parents praise, no? If we do something good or if we make them proud, if we get good percentage and all, so our parents praise us. So, he is praising the boy that yes, they have brought so good things. Won't you praise me too? Said my wife. I have nothing to sow, but I can give you good news. Some useful animals are still alive. A donkey, two goats, six sheep, a ram and a cow. They were nearly dead from starvation, but I was just in time to save their lives by taking food to them. So the wife is like, she is saying in a different manner that, haha, you are praising the boy, you are not praising me, huh? Yes, so she wanted to tell or inform the narrator that she also made the animals survive, like she provided them with food because they had also not eaten food for long time. So as you all know, if animals do not take food or if anyone doesn't take food for too long, they would definitely die, no? So she provided them with food. As a result, they are safe now. All these things are excellent indeed, said I, but Jack here has presented me with a couple of huge, hungry, useless dogs who will eat more than any of us. So one more character, that is Jack, he brought two useless dog, and the narrator is thinking, what's the need of bringing this useless dog, huh? Instead of taking care or doing things for us, they will just eat more than us. Oh, Papa, they will help protect us when we get on shore, cried Jack. So Jack is giving his side's view that definitely when they get on shore, if there is any other animal or if any other dangers prevailing there, then those dogs are going to save them. No doubt they will if we ever do get on shore, Jack, but I must say I don't know how it is to be done. Mr. Robinson is still not sure, like, how are they going to reach to that island? Can't we get into a big tub and float there? Returned he. I have often sailed easily like that round the pond at home. So Jack is reminding the old memories of his, like, previously what he used to do at his home. He used to get a big tub and he used to float. He used to get inside that tub and then he used to float in the pond, isn't it? He used to sail around easily in that pond. So he's giving that idea. My child, that's a brilliant idea, I said. We very soon found four large casks. So as you can see the picture of cask, it is also said as barrels, Okay, it is used to store food. Other liquid items also you can store here. It is made up of good wood and strongly bound with iron hoops. They were exactly what I wanted. With a saw, I cut each cask into half so that we now had 8 tubs. My 8 tubs now stood ranged in a row near the water's edge, and I looked at them with great satisfaction. So as you can see, he has made 8, he has cut the tubs into 2 halves. As you can see, if you cut it from here, you get the 2 tubs, no? So the main character has also done the same thing, and now he could see those things in the water bodies. Next, what he did, I now tied a long rope to the stern of our boat. As you can see, he has tied a rope there, and we began to push. Soon our boats were safely launched. The boat appearing steady, I got in. The boy brought oars to be ready for the voyage. So this is what is called as oars. As you can see, the main character is holding, as well as Fritz is also holding an oar. So basically an oar is used to give direction as well as to increase the speed. If you would have traveled in a boat, no, you would have experienced this. The ducks and geese were set free. They started swimming in water at once. The pigeons, glad to find that they could fly again, swiftly made for the shore. Now, all being ready, we moved away from the wreck. The elder boys took the oars. Everyone wore a float belt and had something useful close to them in case of being thrown into the water. So everyone was having something or the other with them if there is any problem or any difficulty in the way while reaching an island, they could at least be safe. Okay, so they were holding something or the other with them. We had left the two dogs, Turks and Juno, on the wreck, but when they saw us leave without them, they started howling and sprang into the sea. They followed us, occasionally resting their paws on the edges of the float belts around each person. So since Jack brought only two dogs, so those two dogs, as you all know, dogs have very much of affection towards their owner. So in the similar manner here, these two fellows were also having, you can say, affection. Like when they saw that everyone was leaving without them, so they also got worried. They also got into the sea and they were following everyone. And suppose when they got tired, they were resting their foot on the float belts. Oh, look here, father, cried Jack, drawing a little spyglass joyfully out of his pocket. So he was taking out that spyglass and he was putting on his eyes, and he was saying that, okay, look here, father. Let's see what he is trying to show his father. He gave it to me and I started looking towards the island. I soon saw an opening where the stream flowed into the sea. We rowed towards the stream and we found ourselves in a small bay. The water was perfectly smooth and of moderate depth. So now narrator also could see that, yes, now we are going to reach the island, and he was a little bit consoled. He was a little bit happy, you can say, in a very simple language. Definitely after so long journey and 7 days of this fierce storm, they all were very worried, no, whether they would survive or not. The ground seemed plain, on which it was easy for us to land. So now they got to the land. As soon as you land somewhere, you need, no, because they have not gone to that place for a single day or for a vacation. It was just a new place for them. So they wanted something so that they could make a tent, they could pass the night, even food was required, isn't it? So they started looking for a suitable place to make a tent in which to pass the night. When this was done, the boys ran to collect grass to spread in the tent of our beds, while I collected wood to make fire. So they all started finding some things or the others. Like for tent, they were finding some things, as well as the boys went to bring some kinds of grass, because see, since it was a land area, no other organisms could come, insects would be there. So in order to save themselves, so they were bringing the grass over which they could sleep. After a few minutes, I was startled by Jack's cries for help. He was at some point, some distance, and I ran towards his voice. I found Jack standing in a deep pool, screaming. As I came closer, I saw that a huge crab had caught his leg in its powerful claw. I waded through the water and seizing the crab firmly by the back and managed to make it loosen its hold. So he got worried. Jack was crying loudly for help. So when he heard the voice, he started following it. Who is following, children? The narrator, Mr. Robinson. He is following the Jack's voice. So when he found Jack, he could see that Jack was standing in the pool. When he went closer, he found that a huge crab was holding it. I hope you all have seen crab, no? When the crab has got a very powerful grip, when it holds something, it is holding it very tightly. It's definitely going to cause a very great amount of pain. Fritz told us how he had been to the other side of the stream. It is so different from this side, he said. It's really a beautiful country, and the shore, which runs down to sea in a gentle slope, is covered with all sorts of useful things from the wreck. Do let us go and collect them. And father, we can return to the ship and bring back some of the animals. So Fritz is giving idea. He went to the other side also and he found the other wrecked ships as well. So all the things which all were left out, he could get it from there, and even he can get back to the ship and bring the animals which they had left there. Stop, my boy, I said. All will be done in good time. While we were talking, Jack had been unsuccessfully trying to open an oyster with his penknife. Let me show you oysters. Yeah, this is oyster. Yeah, this is the outer cell. You can see this is the outer one. When you open it, you can find pearls also. Some people eat it also. Soon the sun was sinking beneath the horizon. The hens gathered around us and began to pick up the crumbs of biscuit which had fallen while we were having dinner. So it was all going to be night. They all were tired. The hen and all, whatever they brought, they were roaming, they were even picking the crumbs, whatever they were eating, if anything, something falls down, they were having it. Then even wife took out some handfuls of grains, she gave the grains to those poultry, and they all were ready, and they closed their tent, and they all lay down to rest after such a tiring day. It was not just a tiring day, like 7 days, you can think, no, children, such a big problem they were just facing. So this story is written by John David Wiss, and he also had 4 sons, and he wrote this for his family, for his boys. And one more thing, children, this story is basically meant for a family, okay? Like how we take care of our family. We need to value our family. That's what I want to say. See, there will be many differences between you and them. But do remember that they are going to be with you. They are going to help you out. So those things you need to remember. Okay. And you can say we need to understand the family values and the togetherness which we find. Nowadays, since you can see the joint families are not there, people are migrating or going some other places, they are forgetting like what basically family means. I don't know whether you are living in a joint family or not, but the love, the affection, the care you get from family members, I think that's very nice as well as very beautiful. Let's begin. I thought to discuss this answer with all of you. Like this is one imagination question. Like this is all based on your creativity. Just give it a try. Write it on your own, children. Like suppose you were stranded on an island. Think what invention would be useful to it. Just imagine you are in an island. Imagine what would you invent at that moment, or what would you do so that it would be useful to you. So here I am finishing up with this video. Hope you all have understood the chapter well. Read the chapter once again in your book, and Let's finish this one. And huh, don't forget to write the answer of this question.